Are you still single and worried that you'll never find your man, the one for you, your romantic soulmate? Maybe you don't like to admit it, but you feel terribly lonely and even fearful that in your lifetime, you might never be truly and deeply loved. Even if you do feel loved by family and friends, romantic love is still the very life experience you're still yet to experience. Well, stay with me as I'm about to reveal 7 sneaky reasons why you're still single so that you can finally be loved up in that sexy, romantic way. Hi, I'm Nadine Piat, a confidence, dating, and lasting attraction coach for smart, savvy women and the founder of Healthy You, Healthy Love. Now, before we continue, please be sure to comment below and let me know if there's anything specific that you'd like help with and if there's a topic you'd like me to do a video on. I want to find out who you are and what your needs are so I can support you on your path to united and passionate love. And if you're new and haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please click that subscribe button and that bell button to get notified of my next video. So let's get into it. Here are 7 sneaky love blocks that could be standing in your path to wholehearted devoted love. And stay with me until the end, as a number of these 7 points are not what you'd expect. And I also have a fantastic love tool to share with you later. Number 1, you think you need love. Who said there was anything wrong with being single? When you believe you need love to feel better about yourself and to feel validated, you tend to show it with men in somewhat desperate ways. Rather than believing you need love, I suggest you flip your mindset around to valuing romantic love in your life. Rather than forcing love to happen, you're able to attract it and invite it into your life. You can't grab for love. I suggest you dance with attraction and intimacy. And whether you find a true love match or not, you're okay with you. You value and honor yourself, and you'd rather be single than in an unhappy relationship. No one needs to be in a relationship to prove anything. Make peace with your gorgeous single self and be confident with you, single or attached, which is the key mindset to attract the love you want. Number 2, too busy for love. No one is too busy for what they want and value. So why would someone use a busy life as an excuse not to date? Well, maybe they're scared of getting hurt, scared of being rejected. Maybe they have stories that a relationship might take away from their life. Maybe they don't feel sexy enough. They feel that no one will love them. So instead of putting themselves out there, they hide, because dating just feels too darn hard. If you really authentically don't want a relationship right now, I respect this. We weren't all put on this planet to be in a monogamous relationship. This social conditioning does put unnecessary pressure on both men and women to pair up, and yet true romantic love is a lovely life experience. So if you do want to attract big love into your life, perhaps it's time to actively make time for it. You are never too busy for love if you really want it. Number 3, all men are bastards or cheaters. These kinds of stories about men is damaging to you, to men, and society as a whole. For example, believing that men as a gender are all liars and cannot be trusted is simply not true. And not only does this mess with your own psyche, it makes men feel like criminals and stops them from expressing their wants and desires for fear of being viewed as a creep or worse. It just makes attracting love harder for everyone. This has got to stop. Have a look around you. There are plenty, and I mean plenty, of wonderful men in the world. If you choose to date a man who doesn't treat you well, then that's your decision, not a reflection of the whole male race. I encourage you to do some deep healing and rewire your brain to start seeing the kindness and loyalty in so many men. Heal that heart and restore your faith in humanity, in the real possibility of devoted and mindful love. To help you with this, I have a powerful and eye-opening quiz that reveals if you're experiencing one of what I call the 4 romantic love syndromes and how to overcome these so that you can open up your heart to love again. This quiz perfectly relates to each of these 7 sneaky reasons why you might be still single, so that you can quickly find love again and create your ultimate love story. I think you'll love listening to your personalized results, so check it out. Number four, I'm not young enough or pretty enough. I touched on this earlier, and yet it's important to expand on. Everyone can find love. Your soulmate is out there. Most of the population do not look like superstars or supermodels. Love is for everyone, all shapes and sizes, ethnicities, color and culture. Sure, if you want to get fit and eat better, fabulous. This is great for you on so many levels, and yet it's not required. What is required is to get out into the world and meet as many men as you can. App date, internet date, get some hobbies happening, and there's a good chance you'll find a special man. Be joyful, embrace who you are and what you look like. Own it, and I promise you, you will attract more and more of what you want. Men, friends, new opportunities. Start flirting with life and watch it flirt back. Number five, you expect chemistry on the first date. A little while ago, a client worked with me on this very topic. She just met a man, and even though he was nice, she wasn't keen for date two. I asked her, why did he turn you off completely? She said, no, he was just a bit too quiet and serious and didn't seem to be all that interested in her. Basically, there were no fireworks that she believed she needed to feel on date one to even consider date two. But much to her surprise, he did ask her out again. I encouraged her to give him another chance, and guess what happened? They hit it off. They're now married, and it's the best relationship she's ever been in, and she almost let him go. So don't be too quick to rule out a man on the very first or even the first three dates. Nerves can make us do strange things. Some of us can talk a lot more than normal, maybe even talk about things that we normally wouldn't, or we can become super quiet and lose that sparkle, just like this man did with my client. There's a lot to be said for the slow burn. The question is, do you want a relationship or just hot, passionate fun? Sure, you can have both, and yet it's not always obvious from the get-go. Number six, you don't believe that you'll actually find love. You've given dating a good go. You've tried really hard and you're fatigued. But what's worse than fatigue is giving up completely. If you've got some beliefs running around your head like, love just isn't for me, in the end it never works out, all the good men are taken, all men ghost, men only want one thing, I just never get the man I want. If this sounds anything like you, then it's time to dissolve this way of thinking to start believing that you will attract the love you want. When you start believing your ability to attract love, then you will attract love. And while you're at it, also let go of a timeline. Love will happen at the right time for you. The best way to start this is to regularly remind yourself that love is for me. Love seeks me. I'm a love magnet, and start being more loving to yourself and others around you. Stop trying to make love happen. Instead, believe in love for you. And when something doesn't work out, rather than deciding that you're doomed, surrender to it and let go of your expectations and the outcomes. If something feels good, stay open to it. And if it doesn't feel good, let it go. Encourage love, don't force it. Relationships that are not a true match will not work out. And yet the big kind of love you want is out there for you. Believe that it will come to you and you will find each other. And the last point, number seven, too quick to give up. This is somewhat the opposite of the last point. Are you a lazy dater? You'd be amazed how easy women give up on love. So many women bitch and moan about how there are no men out there, and yet they're not dating. They're not out socializing and trying to meet men, and when they are out, they huddle with their girlfriends and give men no opportunity to approach them. If you're not going to make an effort, then why moan and complain? And too many women decide, after only a handful or less of internet dates, that it's useless, tiring. Their men aren't like their profiles, and they declare to never go on a digital date again. And yet, women form relationships with men who they originally met online or via an app every day. You've got to be in it to win it, and saying that all online dating sucks or that there are no men out there is just not true. So there you have it, seven sneaky reasons why you might be still single, and once you overcome these blocks to love, you might just surprise yourself and attract that handsome man you've been dreaming about, because they do exist. to help you create a powerful mindset for dating so that you can attract the perfect man, your soulmate, then I encourage you to learn about my most powerful love techniques, the fear clash and the apple pie technique. They act like attraction and commitment glue. You can get access to these tools in my program, Unlock His Heart, and the link is right below in the description. This program is like a man Bible where I reveal men's secret insecurities and how to dissolve them and what to do if and when a man starts to pull away. That's called the 3 W's technique that every woman needs to know. That's it for today. Again, I'm Nadine Piat. Thank you for spending time with me and remember to show love every day in some special way. If you have a friend who's single and maybe stuck in a rut, then please share this with them as it might be the very video they need to see to attract that love they deeply and even secretly want. I look forward to seeing you at my next video and don't forget to take a second to like this video by clicking the thumbs up icon and please comment below. I'd love to hear from you. While you're at it, click the subscribe button and the bell button to be notified when my newest video is out. I can't wait to see you there.